establishes what gifts should be. Have I got it right? The Bible has already set the standard for gifts. Have we got a witness? Doesn't have to have wrapping paper. Doesn't have to have all of the extras. The Bible in 2 Corinthians, the 9th chapter, and also the 8th chapter, establishes what gifts should be.
Yes.
Have we got a witness? And I lived a long time before I got the message.
All right.
And we got a witness. It says, if you were to look from the first through the 11th verse, and we used to say it for every subject before you, we said, God loves, 9-6, a cheerer.
Yes,
giver. Yeah. Amen. Christmas needs to be celebrated with gift giving.
All right.
Well, Pastor, you just got to talking about it, the gifts of the tree. Christmas is a gift giving time.
Yes.
And so is other worship time. But don't get down on, that is, don't become destroyed over the term gift giving. Because the Lord establishes that. And he establishes right here in this text. And as Paul, as I said earlier in the introduction, is that Paul was soliciting collections from the other churches that were surrounding and around Jerusalem. Because the Jerusalem temple was in disrepair. Have I got a witness? And those persons who went to the Jerusalem temple had gotten the message. So the people in Macedonia and Achaia, they were liberal givers. They didn't have all that the Jerusalem temple had, but they gave so sincerely. And so generously that God had blessed them beyond measure.
All right.
If we could ever get the point across that if you sow sparingly,
you will reap.
Yes, sir.
You're going to reap.
Yes,
all right.
Sparingly.
All right.
If you're going to squeeze a dollar, you're not going to come up with anything but a square dollar. Have we got a witness? And if you can't change your pattern and your conception of giving, is that you will always stay in a pattern of not having anything.
All right.
Because gift-giving was designed by God.
All right.
I wish they had some. It is that I Friday, and this is just an illustration. I was moving some things out of the storage room that I had, and the person asked that I pay the truck. And I knew I didn't have much money left. I wish.
Yes, sir, Paul.
So I went on and did what I needed to do. I got the truck and cleaned down the storage, and which I had paid $3,600 for junk.
All right.
Have I got a witness? And got it into my new home, and there I said, that I can talk about. And he called. He said, Dad, I had talked with him in 2 or 3 weeks. He said, Dad, what is your account number? I jumped up out of the chair.
When it was
to be of service. The first African-American cadet leader, female, has been named at West Point. She was asked, what is there that you learned early on? Even though we're asking you to bring your children every Sunday, so that they can be taught also. She said something that completely got me up out of the chair. She said, is that I learned early on from my mom and from those that were around me in the community that service is given with no expectation of return. The gift givers, have I got a rich, didn't see us out and say, now, if I give myself,
all right,
then you got to give your life,
all right,
or you got to give me $500 a piece for my son.
All right.
He gave, even though there were some who had not accepted.
All right.
And the Lord said, is that you don't get your sleep now because it's all right.
Amen.
It's going to be ringing in your ears. Is that you can't expect to continue to serve